You're listening to the SNHU Weekly Podcast, a show where I explore my world of cybersecurity and online education at Southern New Hampshire University. My name is Giovanni, and I am a freshman majoring in cybersecurity with a focus in project management. Today, I've got some great topics for you. So we are going to be covering week 5 or module 5, depending on how you want to look at it. And so we're going to be talking about different things in module 5. And so I want to give you just some heads up. Okay. What we're going to do is we're going to go over module 5, all of the aspects of module 5, the ones I think you should focus on this week. We're going to talk about my grades in the class. Okay. We're also going to talk about milestone project. As you can see here, this is a big project, 75 points on your score for your class. All right. And again, we're going to talk about the Zybook activities and why those aspects are important. So let's go ahead. We'll get started. But first, before we do that, let's talk about our sponsor. We definitely need to make sure we get them out of the way. We are definitely thankful for them. Of course, our sponsor today is Anchor. If you haven't heard of them, they are the easiest way for you to make a podcast. So when you're listening to this podcast, I make this podcast on Anchor. It is free. They have everything that I need to be able to cut my podcast. And also, I do this in a video format as well. So a lot of times I can just import the audio from the video portion, and Anchor will take care of all of the distribution. They will send it out to Spotify and Apple Podcasts and all of the different aspects where you can actually get podcasts wherever you listen. Okay. Last thing with Anchor, of course, is you can make money from doing your podcast. I know a lot of people, that's what interests them. For me, I'm just interested in a way to distribute my content to people who might be interested in listening to and being, you know, this is primarily made for a active adult who may be on a train or someplace and they just need to hear some things about the course. Maybe you don't know very much about what's going on with this and you're just interested in, hey, maybe you want to go to school for cybersecurity and you want to know what it's like to go to that class. So that's really what this is made for. All right, so let's get into our topic. So in module 5, first things first, okay, just to kind of open it up, this is what your screen, of course, is going to look like and what your classes are going to look like. I've been trying to show more of that as I've had some feedback from people letting me know, you know, they want to see a little bit of what the coursework would be like. So if you're sitting in a seat and you're like, hey, can I actually do this? I can tell you I've been going to school since May of last year. And if I can do this, anybody can do this and go to school. You just have to plan and it has to be a lot of time management, but we'll get to that a little bit later. So you're going to be focusing here. This is going to be your main focus. You're going to be talking about implementing inheritance to demonstrate skills and object-oriented programming. And the whole goal of this week is to be able to integrate multiple classes into a complete object-oriented program. And that is going to be a huge thing. You'll find out about that in a little bit later. So let's go into most of this is just going over information that you're going to have. The part I would really focus my attention in is they give you a module at a glance at the bottom. Why they don't put this at the top, I have no idea, but this would be so much more useful at the beginning, but I digress. So let's get into, let's kind of switch gears here. Here is where my grades stand right now. This is what your grades will look like. And you can always go up into the upper left-hand corner here, go to grades, and you will see exactly what your grades are. And there's no fluff to it. So they will tell you here, your professor will give you comments and different things on what's going on. Finally, he realized that my name was not Steven and I prefer to be called Giovanni, even though my first name is Steven. But my instructor finally realized, hey, his name is Giovanni. Let me call him by the name he prefers. So as you're going down, okay, you can see my grades. I have no shame in showing for those that are on the podcast. We are reviewing week 4. Okay. For the people that are on YouTube, of course, you can see, okay, as of week 4, what did I get? Week 4 on my Zybooks, of course, aced that. 35 points, got an A on that. Zybook activities, got the 20% that was required for that. Now, the part where I got a C minus is for putting in project 1 submission. So I did do the Global RAIN report, and I wrote out all of the pseudocode for it, did my flowchart, but what I failed to do was to submit, and the requirement was to submit something called a pet.java class. Now, I'll explain what happened with that. So at the time, I was being very defiant of using what the school required in order to write my JavaScript. I just didn't like the program that they were using. So I was using my own program. There is a problem with that, though. That will cause you to not be able to submit your documents because they're looking at how often you go onto this site. Okay, this is Southern New Hampshire's way of kind of doing the whole Java programming. So they go through, they put all of this in, and I'm sorry if you hear this in the background, but my Roomba is running right now, but I'm getting this done anyway. We're gonna get it done. So this is the site that they want you to utilize. So just be careful if you want to use a separate program, just make sure that they can see it and at least you going here. I didn't even, to be honest with you, I didn't even know how to get into the site because I completely just was like, no, I'm not using their software to write my code. I have other software that I use, and I use an online compiler to do it. And that's not what they want. They want it to be saved. And as long as it's .java, you can submit the file. So you can use your own software, just make sure you submit the file. That's what happened with this C. So outside of that, the instructor was pretty cool. Let me know that the work was done, but he couldn't, of course, give me full credit for it. If I were to submit my .java file, my grade would go beyond a C, but that's something that I've sent to him already, so this grade will be updated. Now we're going to kind of move into what I think that you should focus most of your week on. Okay, this is your largest project. So this is project 2, at least for right now, this is going to be the largest project. So they will break down in here specifically, again, we're dealing with Global RAIN, okay, which we've been dealing with throughout the whole class and being like a junior software developer for them and kind of going through writing this code. So they give you all of these directions. Okay, so let me read this because this is something you need to pay attention to. If you are on the train, if you are driving, just listen to me. I assure you, pay attention to this part. Your team lead is giving you the specification documents detailing Grisio's salvage software needs. Other members of the Global RAIN development team have already started creating the rescueanimal.java, dog.java, driver.java class files. Your team lead has asked you to modify the existing Java class and create a monkey.java class as your contribution to the team. Okay, the translation of that is your team has already created 3 files and they've done code. So you're going to, one, have to go into their code and figure out what needs to be modified. Second thing is you're going to have to go into and create your own what's called monkey.java class file, and you have to do that from scratch. So that's really what this particular module is about. My thing I want you to focus on is this. Okay, so the instructions tell you what to submit. So it says your submission from this project should be a zipped folder that contains all 4 of your following files, using the download files from Eclipse tutorial material section to help you download these files. So what you're going to do, you're going to turn in a rescue.animal.java file. Of course, that was written by your development team. It says you were not required to make changes to this file, but you must include it as part of your submission. Dog.java, you were not required to make changes to this file, but you must include it as part of your submission. Monkey.java, you created this class from scratch, implementing attributes and a contribution. You should have included all line comments and clear variable naming conventions. That's really what you're going to be graded on, is your variable naming conventions. Driver.java class file. Okay, that's a starter class file. So you got to go into that and really write out the code. So this is what I think you should really focus your week in on, is going through, if you are in a 7 days, okay, what I did to get this project done along with your ZBook activities, okay, which we're going to get to in just a bit. But break this down, okay, into, if you are not very good at JavaScript right now, okay, what I'd recommend. The book is good for me. It doesn't work. I'm more of a visual person, and there's a lot of text that's in that class. And so for me, what I did is I just went and took a Udemy Java course. Okay, so you can go take a Udemy Java course. If you are a veteran, you can sign up for a free premier LinkedIn if you don't have a LinkedIn. And then you can get LinkedIn Learning. LinkedIn Learning is about where that used to be. If you remember Angie's like classwork that she used to have, she used to do video trainings. You can do LinkedIn Learning, which is a video training site, and it is great. You will be able to get, you can get some Java training there if you're more of a visual person. So if you're not strong with Java, start this on a Monday, Tuesday. Okay, don't wait to start it until Friday. This will wreck your whole weekend. So because it's going to take you a while to write the code. So then if you are going on your Tuesday, now you've done this your Monday, Tuesday, and maybe you're done with your driver Java course. Okay. I would just split it into two and then you should be fine. Now, if you're going into your coursework and you now need to do your ZyBook as well. Okay. Let's look at what ZyBook has. Now, ZyBook has basically 11 activities, okay, in order for you to get full credit. You have one lab that you need to do, okay, and that is once you get completely done, you have one lab that you need to finish, okay, you have three challenges that you need to finish, okay, and you need to do your participation. And in order to get 100% on that, you have to do all 10 of your inputs, 11 inputs for that. Okay, and that should take you about 2 hours, okay, if you're doing it all in one sitting, okay, or if you're going to break this down into the week, which I suggest, then on Monday, Tuesday, okay, I would work on my project. Tuesday, Wednesday, I would delve up this, maybe, I'll put it like this, do your project Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, work on your ZyBook work. You should be able to knock this out because you've been going through ZyBooks for quite a while now if you're in the course. So you know how to get through these ZyBook things. This really honestly should take you about maybe 2 hours of just sitting and going through. If you're taking notes and stuff like that, I completely understand. Try to fit this into your Wednesday, Thursday, okay? If you're going to split this and you're like, hey, look, I just need to split this across 5 days, fine. Do this through Monday through Friday, and of these 10, 11 that you need to get done, you should be done where you'll have your Friday free. Okay. That will give you time to really work on checking your project to make sure all your files are ready to go. And you will be able to get back into what is required for this project, which again, I think that is your main thing for this week that you need to focus on. All right. I've taken up a little over 10 minutes of your time and we are done. That is all for week 5, module 5, and we're on to next week's classwork. Today is Monday, the 7th of February, and thank you so much for taking the time to listen to this podcast. Of course, if you enjoy this podcast, you can keep up with me on Twitter. I'm at Diablo Kang, DiabloCain on Twitter. You can DM me there if you prefer. And if this is something that you enjoy, please, by all means, let me know. You can find me online. If you want to be a guest on the podcast, you can send me an email at GiovanniHale@gmail.com. And I'll catch you guys next week.